So I just sign right here?
That's everything that you and Assistant U.S. Attorney Izzo agreed to.
Oh, no, this is quite everything. Why don't we discuss the real reason that you're here?
Yes?
I want an apology.
Apology? For what?
I'm in prison because you made a deal with Don instead of me.
AUSA made that choice.
That was on your advice. So Don gets to get out, and I had to spend my days rotting in here.
Don is dead.
Another thing you probably should apologize for.
Sign. Stand up and let's go.
No apology, no testify. So you can let Hugo Garza go free and clear.
I apologize.
I apologize, Mr. Maslow.
I apologize, Mr. Maslow.
Marty?
Ray!
You're not getting a dime out of Tommy Wheeler. Kill the photos, kill the story.
No fucking way, Ray. Tommy's in a tuxedo. The he-she's wearing a full bridal gown. Unfucking believable.
We had a deal. I gave you Sean Walker's baby less than a year ago.
Yeah, what kind of story is that? He got the egg from his assistant? Big fucking deal.
Big fucking deal.
And I killed all of the Sean Walker Scientology rumors. So we're even. I'm not scared of you anymore.
You should be.
Fuck you! I'm tired of you motherfuckers threatening me for the past 10 years.
I'm not threatening you, Marty.
Very funny.
Very funny.
I've got protection now. I do whatever the fuck I want. I'm gonna time it exactly. It's gonna be great when Tommy's up there accepting his award and all those cell phones start beeping.
Rightly assumed the first of human qualities because it guarantees all others. You know who said that?
Winston Churchill.
Winston Churchill. When I teach my WW2 course, I spend the first 2 weeks on Churchill and the next two on Hitler and Hirohito.
That's an interesting approach.
Can't understand America unless you understand its allies and enemies.
That's true. You have to understand the concept.
I can offer nothing but my blood, toil, sweat, and tears. Churchill, again.
What can I get you, sir?
Another margarita, senorita.
I'm fine, thanks.
Club soda?
Sure.
Well, you don't drink, Max? What is it, like a religious thing or just being frugal? Come on, have extra lime. Hi, my name is Jerry, and I've got to take a leak.
Wait till you have a daughter. This beautiful little bundle of joy with a ponytail and freckles. And then one day, when she's about 15 or 16, she's gonna walk through your front door with a pimple-faced little shit with 20 earrings and zero manners, and she's gonna proceed to tell you how much she loves him because he reminds her so much of you. Now this, my friend, will be one of the worst moments of your life.
Hey, hey, Roscoe. Yeah, talk loud, I'm in the healing waters here.
Excuse me, sir. This is a quiet place.
Well,
hold on, Roscoe. What was that?
Nothing.
It's just that when they asked me to check my gun, they explained it was because this is a quiet, peace-loving place. So why do I have to hear about your stock portfolios, let alone your colon crisis?
You had to check your gun. Who are you?
Never mind me.
Hey, listen, buddy, I have a right to talk. Some of us, we have to work for a living.
Oh, I don't work for a living?
Yeah, no, I'm still here, Roscoe. There's some girly man here in the spa who's in my face, like I need this.
Helen.
Come on, have a seat.
I understand there's reluctance. There always is with a bold new step. But if it turns out that no network is interested, we'll just have to see what Dick Bailey and his friend Howard Hughes will do.
You did brilliant work, Rune.
Thank you.
Everybody at the league, really, the whole country is very, very proud of you.
Thanks for saying so.
The figure's 72 million.
72 million?
Mm-hmm.
For CBS or NBC, maybe, but what's my number?
Well, we're not going to make this personal. I mean, my owners are looking for a big boost here, and ABC has the premier package.
We made you the national pastime, and now you're handing me a bill.
72 million, Rune. Work your magic.
I have 33,000 offspring, all in private school.
I have to get married by Christmas Eve.
Get over here! Right. They're over there, you're over here. What are you doing?
Sorry, Coach.
Are you trying to kill me?
I take it you were never in the Army.
That's a stupid question.
I was. Oh, man, I marched my keister off.
Well, then help me out.
Okay. You see this kid up in the stands here? That's Lou Russ. He was the greatest halfback this school ever had. I had to toss him off the team because of his grades. And now I'm about to lose him for wrestling if I don't get him up.
Bill, what are we talking about? What do you want me to do? Take his tests for him?
No. But I bet if he played in your band, I could talk Jacobs into giving him an academic credit. And then I'll help you out here.
What instrument does he play?
He doesn't. He doesn't play anything.
What are you kidding?
No, he'll fit right in. Glenn, listen. You get him to play anything, and I'll get them to march.
You're not wearing panties, are you?